Hey, welcome back into Good Morning Arkansas. Joel Gordon is here with David Hinson and Tony Bates to share details of a bake-off that doesn't involve a kitchen. Good morning to you, buddy. Always great to see you. I was just playing one of the video games we have here.
Yes.
Okay, so, Joel, tell me about this bake-off.
All right. Well, I'm going to hand this one over to David because this is his baby.
Okay. So, great. Tell me, Dave.
The bake-off.
The bake-off.
3 years ago, Tony and I decided to try to put together a competition to showcase the Raspberry Pi. Mm-hmm. That's a little small credit card-sized computer.
Yep.
It was created by the University of Cambridge Computing Center because they were finding students coming to class not prepared to do coursework. So they developed these cheap $35 computers that kids could come, mess with, break, low consequence, low barrier to entry.
Yeah.
And we figured there were probably tons of hobbyists here in Central Arkansas that had great projects ready to show. We put together an event 3 years ago, and 3 years later, we're still going strong. It's great. It's getting better every year. Yeah, yeah.
Talk about some of the stuff we have here on the table that are all involving the Raspberry Pi.
Excellent. Tony?
We have a little mini arcade cabinet here.
Okay.
It's running some open source games. We have a older game called Descent 2 running on the Raspberry Pi.
Uh-huh. That's what I was just playing, by the way.
Yeah.
It's pretty fun.
We also have a Raspberry Pi robot.
We've done this before, Joel, where we've shown off how the Raspberry Pi is so versatile. And I think that's what makes it so cool and unique and yet really affordable, which is the biggest thing for kids.
It's incredible. You know, it's $35. So on that little robot, we're running a Raspberry Pi B+, which is an older model.
Mm-hmm.
But luckily, Tony, who's the biggest nerd here, honestly, Tony actually already has, this is the newest Raspberry Pi.
Right here.
Yeah, and Tony, can you tell him a little bit about this, the capabilities of this machine?
Well, it's a big upgrade from the old one, of course.
Okay.
It's got a quad-core processor, whereas the original had a single core, a gig of RAM, a lot more GPIO ports where you can actually hook up buttons, relays, LEDs, whatever you want.
The point with this one is that it will run Windows 10. This will run Windows 10, and it's still $35.
So price doesn't change, yet the capability goes through the roof virtually.
Right.
Unbelievable. Right. Okay, so this is something you can get where exactly? Where can you buy them?
You can get them online.
Okay.
Yeah. Right. Newark.com is where you can get them here in the U.S.
Okay.
Adafruit.com is another website you can go and get them from. Typically, depends on the demand. When they first came out, they immediately went into backlog, but you can get them now pretty much within a week or so, depending upon who you order them from.
Caught up from that time.
Yeah, exactly.
And Joel, a lot of kids who come to the Hub, I know you interact with them all the time. Some of them using these.
Oh, yeah.
And kids here in the local community in Arkansas really have embraced the Raspberry Pi.
We did a class yesterday on Python, which is the language that's sort of most prominent with the Raspberry Pi.
Okay.
And had a group of kids together. And the great thing about this is, again, it's so affordable that if you get into it and you change the programming and you mess up the operating system, it doesn't matter because all you're going to do is pull a little SD card like this out of it. You're going to reboot that operating system and you're going to start over. So it's a great way, it's a really approachable way to learn to code and program with no fear. And it's just this amazing little, what's really become sort of a ubiquitous piece of hardware. And there are people who are doing all sorts of projects. There are going to be some great projects there at Raspberry Pi Day at the Bake Off. And it's anything from like Tony's arcade games that are here to the robots to people who are making Raspberry Pi smartwatches, which are a little ridiculous.
Oh my goodness.
But I mean, it's the fact that you can do all of this with this little $35 computer.
And all in celebration of National Pi Day, of course.
Pi Day. Exactly.
And explain why this one is kind of unique and different than some
Well, this being 2015, March 14, 314, so Pi is 3.1415 out to about, you know, a gazillion digits.
Yeah. So we're starting at 9 in the morning, so we can, at 9:26:53, we'll be at 3.14159265 3. So we're 10 decimal points out on Pi Day this year.
I expect something significant to happen on planet Earth at that time. We're not quite sure what it is, but at least you can celebrate and really get one of these online. If your kid's thinking about coding, think about this, folks. So many job opportunities in the future are involving coding and being able to learn how to operate on devices like this and even more sophisticated. So get them started early. Get them something affordable. And these guys, of course, will be here to help you out. So
bring them the Raspberry Pi Bake Off.
Yeah, that's a great way to get started.
It's free at the Hub,
by the way.
The Arkansas Regional Innovation Hub.
Thanks, buddy.
Thanks, man.
Thank you guys for coming in. Really appreciate all the work you guys have done. Coming up next, we're wrapping up the show.